This type of LDL, despite being in normal ranges, is more atherogenic, putting Adam at a significantly higher risk for developing cardiovascular disease. Peace be upon you and welcome back to Mind Human. I'm Dr. Haitham Faraj, a certified cardiologist, nutritionist, and a personal trainer. I'm also the founder of Mind Human, your trusted source for all things health, fitness, and wellness. In today's video, I'd like to address some insightful feedback I received from my recent video on LDL cholesterol. Your comments and perspectives are always valuable, and they've sparked a crucial conversation. Several colleagues recommended that I should place more emphasis on the ASCVD scoring system when making decisions about initiating statin therapy. ASCVD is short for atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease. The scoring system was developed by the American Heart Association and the American College of Cardiology. This tool, based on large-scale cohort studies, such as the Framingham Heart Study, is designed to estimate a person's 10-year and lifetime risk of heart attack and stroke. It is widely used by physicians to guide decisions regarding statin therapy and other preventive interventions in line with current clinical guidelines. Today, we'll take a deeper dive into this approach and explore its strengths and limitations. While the ASCVD score is a valuable tool and widely used, it might not always give us the full picture. We need to look beyond the numbers and focus on the patient's overall metabolic health and lifestyle to make well-informed decisions. Now let's look at two real-world examples. Meet Adam. Adam is a 45-year-old male with an unhealthy lifestyle. He is overweight, consumes food high in refined carbs, doesn't engage in regular physical activity, and leads a largely sedentary life. His blood pressure is 120 over 80 millimeter mercury. His total cholesterol is 230 milligrams per deciliter with an HDL of 40 milligrams per deciliter and an LDL of 140 milligrams per deciliter, which is considered borderline high. He is on hypertension medications, has never smoked, and doesn't have diabetes. According to the ASCVD score calculator, Adam's 10-year risk of cardiovascular event is 3.5%. That's considered low risk. No statins recommended, but let's take a deeper look. Now meet Ali. Ali is also a 45-year-old male, but he leads a healthy lifestyle. He goes to the gym regularly, eats clean, and is very conscious of his health. His blood pressure is slightly better at 118 over 75 millimeter mercury. However, his total cholesterol is 280 milligrams per deciliter with an HDL of 90 milligrams per deciliter and an LDL of 190 milligrams per deciliter, which is quite high. Based on this alone, the ASCVD score jumps to the conclusion that Ali is at high risk. The ASCVD score immediately advises statin therapy for Ali, but is this the full picture? Let's dive deeper. The ASCVD score doesn't take triglycerides into account, which are a crucial marker of cardiovascular health. Adam's triglycerides are 150 milligrams per deciliter, while Ali's, the healthy individual, are lower at 100 milligrams per deciliter. Additionally, the score overlooks other vital markers like ApoB and lipoprotein A, both of which play a key role in cardiovascular risk assessment, as elevated levels are associated with a higher risk of cardiovascular disease. Adam's ApoB is actually high at 100 milligrams per deciliter, and his lipoprotein A is borderline high at 40 milligrams per deciliter, while Ali's ApoB is 85 milligrams per deciliter, and his lipoprotein A is a much lower 18 milligrams per deciliter. So what does this tell us? Let's break it down by calculating their triglyceride to HDL ratio, a key marker of metabolic health, as we discussed in our previous video. For Adam, his ratio is 150 divided by 40, giving us a result of 3.75. This is considered quite high and serves as a red flag. A ratio this elevated strongly suggests that Adam's LDL particles are likely the smaller, dense, and more harmful type, known as LDL pattern B. This type of LDL, despite being in normal ranges, is more atherogenic, putting Adam at a significantly higher risk for developing cardiovascular disease. In contrast, Ali's triglyceride to HDL ratio is 100 divided by 90, which equals 1.1, very low. This suggests that Ali's LDL is the larger, buoyant, and less harmful type, known as LDL pattern A. which is far less likely to contribute to heart disease. Now, here is the problem. According to the ASCVD score, Adam, despite his unhealthy metabolic profile, wouldn't be prescribed statins. Meanwhile, Ali, a healthy individual, would be prescribed statins purely based on his LDL levels. This example demonstrates a major flaw in relying solely on the ASCVD score. It treats everyone the same, ignoring unique metabolic health and activity levels. Yes, the ASCVD score is a useful tool, but it should never be used in isolation. It provides a snapshot, but not the full picture. Cardiovascular disease risk is more than just LDL levels. It's about the type of LDL, triglyceride levels, degree of insulin resistance, ApoB, and lipoprotein A levels, and of course, your overall lifestyle. So what's the solution? The solution is a more comprehensive approach, one that includes traditional risk factors, but also considers metabolic markers like the triglyceride to HDL ratio, lipoprotein A, and ApoB levels, while factoring in lifestyle and physical activity. This enables us to provide more personalized care and avoid blanket statin prescriptions that may not always be necessary. Now, to be fair to evidence-based medicine, one critical consideration in Ali's case is his elevated LDL levels, which could be a sign of familial hypercholesterolemia, a genetic condition that can be suspected when LDL levels reach or exceed 190 milligrams per deciliter. In such cases, I would recommend genetic testing. If the results confirm familial hypercholesterolemia, I would initiate statin therapy, despite his low triglyceride to HDL ratio, low ApoB, and lipoprotein A, because individuals with this condition face a significantly higher risk of cardiovascular disease. In such cases, lowering LDL becomes essential. However, if Ali's genetic test comes back negative, there will be no justification for statin therapy. His elevated LDL is likely contributing to his health by transporting testosterone, which fuels his energy, vitality, and overall well-being. Prescribing statins in this case could disrupt the balance, diminishing his vitality and potentially causing more harm than good. Before we wrap up, I want to thank everyone for the feedback and stories shared after my last video on LDL cholesterol. I was particularly touched by comments from Fredo and Sweetlove, who shared personal experiences with statins and the importance of understanding their metabolic health. Fredo shared how their GP prescribed statins without discussing LDL particle types, despite normal markers. Sweetlove shared a powerful story about choosing not to take statins 30 years ago after doing her own research. Hearing how the content of my video resonated with you means a lot to me. Thank you both, and to everyone who continues to engage in this critical conversation. I also want to address a comment from Richard, who sadly shared that his LDL level is 184 milligrams per deciliter. Richard, thank you for reaching out. I understand your concern. But remember, LDL is just one piece of the puzzle. I can't make a recommendation without knowing more about your overall health and lifestyle. Statin therapy is not a decision that should be based on LDL levels alone. If you're diabetic, your LDL levels may be an indicator of insulin resistance, and statin therapy might be indicated. However, if you're otherwise healthy with a low triglyceride to HDL ratio, statins may not be necessary. Each case is unique, and it's essential to look at the complete picture before making any decisions. I hope this video has provided clarity on why we can't rely on a single score to make such important decisions. If you have any questions or thoughts, feel free to share them in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe to support the channel and join us in our mission to improve the health of this sick planet. Also, visit mendhuman.com for personalized health transformation programs and resources to take control of your well-being. Thank you for watching, and until next time, stay healthy and stay empowered. Peace be upon you. Assalamu alaikum.